Hi, and welcome back. In the last video, we discussed the common property sets, which are automatically attached to your IFC elements when exporting from Revit. You can think of these as of the ID documents of your elements with certain fields which need to be filled. Of course, not all the properties we use and need in our projects are part of the IFC schema, so we often need to create our own property sets, and this is something we'll have a closer look at today. Now, if you have your exporter still set to the default settings, you'll notice that the IFC common property sets are active by default. The first option, the Revit property sets, is in general not the best option because this will export all the properties from Revit according to their internal grouping, and this will not only increase your file size but also clutter your IFC with a lot of data you don't need and which only makes sense inside of Revit. What you want to do is group and structure your data in a meaningful way, and this is something which can be done using the custom or user-defined parameter sets in Revit. There are two ways to create these in Revit, using the schedules or the parameter mapping file. First, let's have a look at the schedule. Creating parameter sets through schedules in Revit is very fast and easy, and I use it on a regular basis. For this, let's go ahead, create a schedule in Revit. Pick the walls category, and I'll call the schedule Psets Bimmy Up and add a couple of properties. At this point, it doesn't really matter which properties, we just want to see how this works. I'll also mix the instance and type properties to show you how this is exported. Now, when we go ahead and export this file, we can select the option to export schedules as Psets and also restrict it to the schedules with the code word IFC, Pset, or common in the title. In my project, this doesn't make a big difference because I only have this one schedule, but in big projects, obviously, this is a great option to use. After the export, you can see that we have a new PSET created. Since we combined instance and type parameters in our schedule, you will also find the same PSET on the type level, which stores the type properties from Revit on this level separately. These are then passed through to the instance and combined with the instance properties on this level as well. Note the different IFC viewers display the property sets on the type and entity level in a different way. And this is, for example, how you can view the same property sets in the FZK viewer. The reason why the schedules are not always the preferred solution is that they are stored inside of the Revit project and therefore not so easily shared between the projects, and they can also be easily deleted or changed by a Revit user. Therefore, let's have a look at the mapping table. If you go to the export settings and property sets, you will notice that there is a template file for the mapping table already linked here. It is again a simple text file, similar to what we already used for the common property sets, but it is a bit more complex, which is why it also has some guidelines included. Everything starting with the hash mark is commented out, which means it won't be read by the exporter. And you can also use a hash mark to add your own comments and instructions to this file. To start creating our own property set, we will go ahead and start a new line and choose a property set name. These entries or columns are separated by a tab. After another tab, we need to select instance or type level. This is not relevant in newer versions anymore because you can combine instance and type parameters as needed. So you can just proceed by entering an I, for instance. Finally, we need to select which classes this property belongs to. Here you can either specify IFC wall if you want to add this PSET to your walls only. You can add several classes by separating them with a comma. So for example, IFC wall, comma, IFC window, and so on. Or you can use IFC building element to add it to all your elements. If we have a brief look at the IFC schema, you will notice that for each entity you can find the inheritance graph. Here you can easily find out which is the next higher entity you can address. And by going one level higher in our case to IFC element, you are also including furniture or the MEP elements which are found under the IFC distribution element. After this, we can start adding the properties. We need to specify the property name and the data type in the IFC file. The supported data types are listed in the instructions at the beginning of the file, and the most relevant ones are a text, integer, and number for the decimal numbers. For the case the property name in Revit and the desired name in the IFC file are not the same, we can easily map them here by adding the Revit property name to the third column. Otherwise, the exporter will simply assume that the name of the Revit and IFC property are the same. We can add as many properties as we need using this method and also define further property sets in the same file. Simply start a new line with the same syntax. When saving this file, please double check it is saved in the UTF-8 format by your text editor. When exporting, we can now reference this file and hit export. As you can see, this method created our Psets in the IFC file as intended. Just like with the schedule, we also have the corresponding Pset on the type level showing the type properties from Revit, while the one on the instance level contains both type and instance properties. Hope this showed you that it is not hard at all to create your own property sets in Revit. Using this method, you can basically export all the properties you need from Revit in a structured and meaningful way. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.